Hello, we are the SpaceX fans and welcome to the SpaceX Show, the place where you can stay up to date with everything SpaceX. To kick off this video, there was a slight delay to the next Starlink launch with it being pushed later into the day. As you can see on the SpaceX fans website, the Starlink 4-3 launch is expected to lift off today at 11:20 PM UTC or 6:20 PM EDT. There is a Space News article posted in relation to SpaceX's Starlink satellite internet service. It says India's government has told SpaceX to stop taking pre-orders for Starlink broadband services in the country until it has a license to operate there. There was some news about NASA calling off a spacewalk due to orbital debris. Somebody tweeted at Musk saying, becoming quite an issue. Elon Musk responded with, "We had to shift some Starlink satellite orbits to reduce probability of collision. Not great, but not terrible either." Station and Dragon have micrometeorite shields, ultra-high velocity impact absorption, but EVA suits do not, hence higher risk for spacewalk. There was a somewhat worrying article that has been posted by Space Explored. It says, in an email sent to SpaceX employees obtained by Space Explored, Elon Musk addressed the crisis of Starship Raptor engine development and said the company could face a genuine risk of bankruptcy if the company is unable to achieve a Starship flight rate of once every 2 weeks next year. In response to an article posted about this, Musk posted a couple of tweets. The first says, if a severe global recession were to dry up capital availability or liquidity while SpaceX was losing billions on Starlink and Starship, then bankruptcy, while still unlikely, is not impossible. Then he also posted saying, the magnitude of the Starship program is not widely appreciated. It is designed to extend life to Mars and the Moon, which requires approximately 1,000 times more payload to orbit than all current Earth rockets combined. There was a Teslarati article posted related to Dragon capsules. It says state media agency RIA says that NASA and Roscosmos are negotiating an agreement that would eventually allow SpaceX Dragon spacecraft and other future visiting vehicles to dock to the new Russian node module recently installed on the International Space Station. Heading over to Boca Chica, here's a view of the orbital launch mount and chopstick catching arms. Here's an up-close view of the orbital launch mount plumbing as they continue to assemble the structure. The hood for the booster quick disconnect continues to be worked on in the production yard. Also in the production yard, you can see the current progress on the wide bay here. Beams are continuing to be constructed for the wide bay to continue rising. Somebody asked Musk, how's the Raptor thing going? He responded and said it's getting fixed. Everyday Astronaut also posted a tweet saying, my understanding of the Raptor production problem is mostly the huge investment in Starship, Starlink 2.0 or receiver and other things relying on Starship. So, until Starship flies, often there is a potential cash flow issue and Raptor production is the biggest risk for bottleneck. Musk responded with, yes. Musk was asked, will SpaceX redesign suits for Moon and Mars missions? He responded with, suits will need to be made in high volume at an affordable cost and be much easier to use. There was a tweet posted about an article saying planetary scientists are starting to get stirred up by Starship's potential. Musk responded with, Starship will enable a quantum leap in deep space and planetary science. This new smooth nose cone was spotted, apparently destined for the scrapyard. Engineers were seen doing some work near Starship 20's body flaps. We could see some more testing soon with another static fire of Ship 20, so we'll take a look at the Roden Beach closures on the Cameron County website. There's a closure expected today as well as tomorrow December 2nd and Friday 3rd. Then there's also another closure scheduled for next week on Monday December 6th. In addition to the date posted for today, Mary posted a tweet about an alert she received for testing. So, we could see another static fire test today for the Starship 20 prototype. Crews are continuing to work on Starship 21's nose cone heat shield tiles. The Ship 21 body section still has yet to receive its aft flaps. Crews continue to work on preparing the Super Heavy Booster 4 prototype at the launch site. The Booster 6 common dome section was recently flipped into the correct orientation. As always, thanks to both Mary or Boca Chica Gala Nick Ansuini for being out there filming the amazing Starbase content. Also, thanks to the NASA spaceflight team working behind the scenes on their great videos, live streams, and other space content. That's it for this episode of the SpaceX Show. I hope you enjoyed the video. If you did, make sure to hit the like button and leave a comment down below. If you want to stay updated with SpaceX info, make sure to subscribe and press the bell icon to get notified when I upload. Thanks for watching and have a great day.